Good afternoon and welcome to Saints Peter and Paul. We're so glad to welcome you today, especially those of you who may be visiting us this weekend. We hope that during this Mass you experience the peace of Christ with us. Now today we celebrate the fifth Sunday of Ordinary Time. And so let us stand together and pray the prayer to the Holy Spirit that can be found on the cards in the hymnals. Holy Spirit, may the same fire of love which inflames the Sacred Heart of Jesus and the Immaculate Heart of Mary inflame our hearts so that through prayer and boldness in word and ministry, everyone in our parish and our local community will encounter Jesus, grow in faith, and witness the faith in word and deed. Amen. Come, Holy Spirit, fill the hearts of your faithful and kindle in them the fire of your love. Send forth your Spirit, and they shall be created, and you shall renew the face of the earth. O God, who did instruct the hearts of the faithful by the light of the Holy Spirit, grant that by the same Holy Spirit we may be truly wise and ever enjoy his consolations through the same Christ our Lord. Amen. And we do ask you to replace the cards in today's hymnal for the readings at number 941. Again, that's number 941. And then join us for our gathering hymn, Come Christians, Join to Sing.
Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
As we prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries, let us call to mind God's mercy and love. Lord Jesus, you were sent to heal the contrite. Lord, have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
You came to save sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You plead for us at the right hand of the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O Lord, keep your family safe with unfailing care, so that relying solely on the hope of heavenly grace, they may be defended always by your protection. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
A reading from the book of Job. Job spoke, saying, "Is not man's life on earth a drudgery? Are not his days those of hirelings? He is a slave who longs for the shade, a hireling who waits for his wages. So I have been assigned months of misery, and troubled nights have been allotted to me. If in bed I say, 'When shall I rise?' then the night drags on. I am filled with restlessness until the dawn. My days are swifter than a weaver's shuttle. They come to an end without hope. Remember that my life is like the wind. I shall not see happiness again." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, if I preach the gospel, this is no reason for me to boast, for an obligation has been imposed on me, and woe to me if I do not preach it. If I do so willingly, I have a recompense, but if unwillingly, then I have been entrusted with a stewardship. What then is my recompense? That when I preach, I offer the gospel free of charge, so as not to make full use of my right in the gospel. Although I am free in regard to all, I have made myself a slave to all, so as to win over as many as possible. To the weak, I became weak, to win over the weak. I have become all things to all, to save at least some. All this I do for the sake of the gospel, so that I too may have a share in it. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. On leaving the synagogue, Jesus entered the house of Simon and Andrew with James and John. Simon's mother-in-law lay sick with a fever. They immediately told him about her. He approached, grasped her hand, and helped her up. Then the fever left her, and she waited on them. When it was evening, after sunset, they brought to him all who were ill or possessed by demons. The whole town was gathered at the door. He cured many who were sick with various diseases, and he drove out many demons, not permitting them to speak, because they knew him. Rising very early before dawn, he left and went off to a deserted place where he prayed. Simon and those who were with him pursued him, and on finding him said, "Everyone is looking for you." He told them, "Let us go on to the nearby villages, that I may preach there also. For this purpose have I come." So he went into their synagogues, preaching and driving out demons throughout the whole of Galilee. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Today is the feast of St. Blaise, Bishop and Martyr. For those of you who need reminding, he was a bishop in the early church, and as he was going off to his martyrdom, he was traveling through a town and a child was choking on a fishbone. And so he blessed the child's throat and out popped the fishbone. And ever since that time, he is known as the patron saint of throats and throat ailments. And so I figure I will give you a general blessing right now, and then after Mass, I will be standing up here offering individual blessings for those who would like it. So, through the intercession of St. Blaise, Bishop and Martyr, may God deliver you from every disease of the throat and from every other illness. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. So, this blessing was there to give you, cure you, deliver you from every disease of the throat and for every other illness. And my guess is a lot of you just wanted this to be so that you don't get the flu, you don't get COVID, you don't get a cold. And if you really went for broke, you might be saying, well, maybe it'll cure cancer. You know, we're always wanting to have that cure, that physical cure from this blessing. And that's exactly what the crowds were wanting from Jesus too. You know, he goes over to Simon's mother-in-law and cures her. And the word gets around. And all of a sudden, after sunset, meaning after the Sabbath when you could actually walk, people then started to gather around. People wanted to be cured of every disease and illness themselves. They gathered around Jesus, and they gathered, and they gathered. And then finally, it was enough. He had to dismiss the crowds, and he went off to the mountain to pray alone. I stop and think about, okay, what would it be if I was in that crowd? That I have a disease, I have an illness, I want Jesus to cure me. But then all of a sudden, Jesus, you know, I'm like second from Jesus, reaching Jesus, and he turns around and goes off to the mountain to pray. And so I think to myself, okay, no problem. I'll just wake up early in the morning next day, and I'll go hunt him down. I mean, everybody's looking for you, and that's what they are. Okay, Jesus, come back and cure me. And yet he says no. I'm just amazed that Jesus is saying no. Instead, he goes off to the other towns and villages to preach. And here I am. I'm in the one who said I wanted there, and now I'm. How am I supposed to feel about Jesus leaving me with my illness while he goes off to go preach elsewhere? Am I mad at Jesus saying, well, couldn't you just spend a little time and cure me? What is it that you wouldn't take the time? Would I get angry at the crowd saying, you should have told me earlier? Or maybe there was other people in front. Maybe if y'all, the other people, weren't such hogs and taking up Jesus' time, I would have gotten my cure. Maybe I just blame myself, saying that maybe it's my fault that I didn't get my cure. I should have been more on the ball. Whatever it is, Jesus didn't cure. So why did he want the cure? And in the end, I asked myself, why did I want this cure? As I gave the blessing for the throats, why is it that I want this cure? And I answered myself, it's usually physical. I want to be like I was when I was 25. I want to be able to go and run 5 miles and not worry about my knee giving out. I want to go eat the most red sauce-filled pizza at 8 o'clock at night and be able to go to sleep knowing that I won't get sick in an hour. I want to have all those things that I used to do. Basically, I want to live. I want to turn back the clock. And as these people are coming to Jesus who are ill, they're wanting to turn the back the clock as well. And yet we can't. In the first reading, we have the prophet Job, or the book of Job, where everything's taken away from him bit by bit. You know, all his money gets wiped away in a single moment. All his family gets wiped away in a single moment. His health gets wiped away in a single moment. All of a sudden, everything that he has is taken away from him. And indeed, he says, my life is like a weaver who severs the last thread. And if you ever know anything about a weaver, they're like, they move back and forth on their loom. And so it feels like it's so useless. I'm going back and forth, back and forth, back and forth. And my days will come to an end. Do I want to ask Jesus for my life again? Am I asking to be healed again? And so when Jesus turns around and doesn't come back to cure all the people who are waiting, and if I'm one of those in the middle of the town waiting to be cured, why? In the end, the physical healings don't last. Everybody in that Jesus cured died. Even if I got the miracle that I wanted, I'll die too. Everybody dies. In the sense, Job is right. But yet, there is that one thing that lasts forever. It's that eternity that Jesus is proclaiming. He goes out and proclaims. He focuses on the thing that lasts forever, which is eternal life, which is salvation, which is redemption, which is the reason why he came here in the first place. He came here to save us from our sins. And yes, curing every disease and illness is great, but in the end, it doesn't last. What does last is that conversion. Think about, as we heard from the letter of Paul, what illness did Paul get cured of? I can't think of any. What illness do you reflect on with the apostles? Did they get cured of? I can't think of any. And yet they got the salvation that they desperately needed. And so when I come back to the one thing that I ask myself, what is it that I wanted when I asked for this blessing from St. Blaise? And the answer comes back wholeheartedly, I want to live. Rather than asking for what lasts forever. Jesus invites us to listen to his voice and to experience his love and mercy and salvation. And yes, he does offer healing, but the most important healing is that comes from our heart. This blessing that we have this day is a call to me to reflect and look upon myself and say, what is it that I'm truly asking for? What is it that's truly nearest and dearest to my heart? To live a little bit longer, to live a little bit better, or to live for salvation? And so I close with this to give you too the opportunity to reflect. And to ask again, what is it that you want? Through the intercession of St. Blaise, Bishop and Martyr, may God deliver you from every disease of the throat and from every other illness. In the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. I believe
one God,
the Father Almighty,
maker of heaven and earth,
of all things visible and invisible.
I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God,
born of the Father before all ages,
God from God, light from light,
true God from true God, begotten not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men, for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake, crucified on Pontius Pilate, he suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and life of the world to come. Amen.
We bring all our petitions before our Heavenly Father.
For all leaders and decision makers in the church, that they may always prioritize the salvation of souls and lead with genuine love and humility, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the world to be lifted up beyond violence, pride, and hatred, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who experience suffering and trials, just as Job did, that they may find strength and perseverance in their faith, We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For good health, spiritual wholeness, and increased longing for Jesus each day within our parish family, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who suffer from illnesses and infirmities, as well as those who care for them, that they may find comfort and healing in God's loving presence, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the members of our parish community who have died may be welcomed into God's kingdom, especially Bill McAtee, for whom this Mass is being offered, and for Bernard Jr. Wempe and Peggy Holdner, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, we ask you to hear and answer all our petitions, for they're offered through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Awesome wonder,
pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
The Lord accept the sacrifice of your name.
O Lord our God, you once established these created things to sustain us in their frailty. Grant that they may become for us now the sacrament of eternal life. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For out of the compassion for the waywardness that is ours, he humbled himself when he was born of the Virgin. By the passion of the cross, he freed us from unending death. By rising from the dead, he gave us eternal life. With angels and archangels, with thrones, dominions, with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Make holy, therefore, these gifts by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered together into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Thomas John, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. us pray for the coming of the kingdom, as our Savior taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, from every evil. Grant peace in our days. By the help of your mercy, may we be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we wait the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you." Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. Grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Peace be with you. Peace be with you. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter into my roof, but only say the word, my soul shall be healed.
For those who cannot now receive Jesus in the Blessed Sacrament, we offer the following prayer. My Jesus, I believe that thou art present in the Blessed Sacrament. I love thee above all things, and I desire thee in my soul. Since I cannot now receive thee sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. As though thou wert already there, I embrace thee and unite myself wholly to thee. Permit me not that I should ever be separated from thee. Amen.
I am weak, I am worn.
Let us pray. O God, you have willed us that we be partakers in the one bread and the one chalice. Grant us so to live that, made one in Christ, we may joyfully bear fruit for the salvation of the world. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated.
Good afternoon. My name is Steve Knable. I'm the new Cub Master for Cub Scout Pack 83 here at St. Peter and Paul. St. Peter and Paul has sponsored the Cub Scouts and Boy Scouts for 75 years. There are many parishioners and members of our community that were Boy Scouts from Troop 83. Over the years, about 70 of those Boy Scouts became Eagle Scouts. Eagle Scout is the highest rank in Scouting. Less than 5% of those who enter Scouting become Eagle Scouts. I was a member of Troop 83 for my Scouting years and became an Eagle Scout. Scouting was a huge part of my life growing up. I was able to go to the National Jamboree in Washington, D.C. and Philmont Scout Ranch in Cimarron, New Mexico, where we backpacked over 100 miles in 10 days through the mountains. Summer camp, hikes, bike rides, weekend campouts, cooking, orienteering, wilderness survival, canoeing, rifle shooting, first aid, and religious medals. These are just some of the hundreds of activities that you can experience in Scouts. You will learn many skills that will help you through your life, including working as a team and leadership. There are many great opportunities in Scouts. It is a great way to try new things and learn lots of new life skills. If you know a child that would be interested in trying Scouts, please talk to one of us in the gathering space after Mass. Thank you.
And don't forget that the Knights of Columbus Ladies Auxiliary video series begins next Saturday, February 10th at 9 a.m. and will be in Morris Hall. As always, you can see the bulletin for more information about this. Also, next weekend, the Pro-Life and Social Concerns Committee will be sponsoring their second annual pie raffle. Tickets will be available before and after all of the masses in the gathering space, and the proceeds will benefit our sister parish, Holy Cross, in Guatemala. The Knights of Columbus are sponsoring a blood drive this coming Monday, February 5th, at St. Stephen's in Caseyville. They are in desperate need of blood donations, and if they don't get enough donors signed up, they will be forced to cancel the drive. You may see the bulletin or flyers for more information. And finally, Ash Wednesday and the season of Lent are quickly approaching. Masses for Ash Wednesday will be on February 14th at 8:15 a.m. and then again that evening at 6:30 p.m.
As I stated in my homily, I'll be standing up here rather than processing out to give people who would like individual blessings a chance to have those. Please stand. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go and announce the gospel of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.